Yeah, I had this little bad thing, something like them tens, something like the whiz. But you see the sad thing with her is dummy like a. So I try to show her about the world and about just who we really are and where we've come and how we still have to go really far. Like, baby, look at how we live broke on the boulevard. But all she ever want me to do is then all I really want. Before you know it, she and all that deep I was previously down for, replaced by I am currently down for. You see, I peaked it. It's power, that proud feeling we get knowing that is ours, and how it feels to feel that feeling you feeling when you be gotta sing, and all the pain the world caused, she be healing that, and all that ain't your girl, dog, but you be, and you just wanna tell her everything she might need, but in the meantime, it's lights, please, lights, please, lights, please, turn off the lights, for now, everything just seems so right. How you make the darkness seem so bright? I'm feeling like things gon' be alright. Lights please, turn off the lights. For now, everything just seems so right. And how you make the darkness seem so bright? I'm feeling like things gon' be alright. So now we in a hotel. She say she wanna, I hear her and I'm willing. But every time I, well, in mind gone, so that every word I spoke, well, I'm trying to put her on, but she couldn't hear me. I told her all about how we've been living a lie. See, it's all go to like, baby, look at how they show us on the TV.
So Memphis will get the first possession. Well, we know the players enjoyed the rest they get during All-Star Weekend. But, Greg, do you think it should be moved to later in the season?
I like how the current format splits up the season, but it seems more fair to hold an All-Star towards the end of the season so that voters get a more complete look at each player, taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
A point guard getting up like that? Boy, that is special.
Now here's Morant. That doesn't fall either. He's missed his first two shots tonight. On the wing, Harris. Here's Embiid. Good. And Harris gets the assist.
Just another thing that makes Embiid unguardable. He can hit shots from any spot on the floor.
Here's Morant. And finished off by Morant.
Wow, look at how quick he flashes to the rim there for the finish.
Here's Brown. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Grizzlies will take it. And just over a minute played here in the start of the game. Well, Greg, with this Memphis Grizzlies team, you like how young and how hungry they are. It's very appealing.
And these players have bought into the system. This is a selfless group that knows each other's strengths, and it's why they've seen so much success here of late.
Just three to shoot. Morant with another miss.
He just looks off this quarter. Looks like he's forcing it a bit right now, a little bit in his head.
Harris finds Maxey. The kick out to Brown. No good on the three. Grizzlies have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Here's Morant. And Morant throws it down.
Okay, I see you, Ja, flexing a little bit of muscle, showing off that athletic ability. Okay.
Up top, Brown. Now the pass to Tucker. Tucker gets a screen from Brown. Shoots over Morant. The 76ers with another miss. Memphis has gone 0-2 from deep here. And since coming into the league, Desmond Bain, Richard, is
at the line for the Grizzlies, Desmond Bain, taking two shots.
Amazing that Bain fell to the last pick in the first round in 2020. You look at his size, the strength, the range on his jump shot. When shooting's a premium, he should have been drafted earlier. Normally, he sinks all of his free throws. The defense got lucky there. He just didn't like what he saw inside, so he takes the open transition three. But if he'd missed, Coach might have had some words for him.
He also loved that Bane absolutely puts in the work.
Oh, high effort guy, high IQ, knows exactly where to be. Bright future.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. He'll gladly take those.
Now, here's Bane. His last outing, 16 points for him. Brooks, the pass to Bane. Bane with the screen on Brown. From deep, Brooks. And again, Memphis, no good. Looking at Philadelphia, they took the win in their last game against the Cavaliers in Cleveland.
Yeah, mental toughness on the road. The arena was rocking, but they just got down to business and never let up.
And the mental game you talk about, a lot comes down to coaching, having your players focused.
Now here's Morant, and it's in there. Morant got his third basket of the night. Timeout, right?
This is a blue. You guys are
the Grizzlies trail by 10. The wingmen are Bane and Brooks. Adams is the pivot for him with Jackson Jr. at the four. And it's Jones in at the point. That's the group for Memphis to kick off the second quarter. Now Harden. After the miss, three from Desmond Bane. Back to Harden. It's Brown on the win. And he drives in. And finished off by Brown.
Oh, there is nothing more fun than putting a big guy on a poster. That is the definition of an aggressive play.
And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up for the Grizzlies. They've got the Pistons ahead of them in their next game in Detroit. That'll be just one game played away from home for them. Memphis moving that ball around. That's good. And it's Jackson with the assist that time. Jones has got 9.
The team first mindset of Jackson, willing to get the ball to his open guys.
Down kicks to Embiid. Stolen by Brooks. And a wide open look for Bane. He gets it to fall. That makes it just a single-digit lead.
Oh, smart dish there by Brooks to a wide open man, getting him the assist and his team some needed points.
Pass to Harris. Brown outside. Pass to Reed. Back to Brown. Over Jones. And the shot is long. The Grizzlies trail by 7.
When you have an MVP caliber player like Joel Embiid, you have to be in win mode now. And the Sixers are doing everything they can to get their big fella to the finals.
With a short break. And the action gives us a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge.
Thank you, guys. Now, Tobias Harris has been the leading scorer on teams in the NBA, but on the Sixers, he understands his role is different. He says, I'm not a guy who's going to press for looks. The ball is going to flow how it flows, and I just got to be ready when the opportunity comes my way. That's what winning basketball is all about. Kevin?
David, thank you. Is it hard, Richard, to balance the present? In the future, if you're a team like the 76ers?
No, you should have 100% focus on here and now. Why? Because players like Embiid only come around every 20, 30 years in your franchise. So you should just hedge all of your bets and try and get it done while you have the window.
And it feels like that is truly the direction. There's no deviating from it at all.
No, that's the direction. You look at the champions, the Golden State Warriors, the Milwaukee Bucks, the Lakers, they have all done the same thing.
That's not a foul. Are you kidding me?
First team shooting for Philadelphia, Joel Embiid, taking two shots.
Shooting two.
What can you say about Joel Embiid's growth from a leadership perspective? Pretty impressive, isn't it?
Tremendous, Kevin. Carrying the Sixers with everything they went through. Even though he came in second in MVP voting 2 years in a row, no player more important to his team than Joel Embiid.
John Morant, he's checked in for the Grizzlies.
Inside, outside, mid-range, Brooks has the accuracy to make whatever look he gets work for him.
Brown the pass to Embiid. A shake. It's rebounded by Memphis. And this is the first season matchup for them against this 76ers team.
It's not often we get to see this matchup, but it is a doozy when we do. Just two powerhouse teams facing off.
And who knows, if you want to look all the way ahead to the finals, it's possible these teams could see each other there. So both teams looking to make a statement in their first meeting of the season.
Buries the long-range jumper.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Yeah, I love the competitive fire right there. You drain a triple on us, and I'm coming for my...
He has some impressive moves in his repertoire. That's as good as it gets, but just one of many.
Pound kicks to Harris. Maxi passes to Tucker. And here is Brown. Nice. 4 for 7 from the floor with that shot.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Shots, taking advantage of his size and frame.
Maxey with it, now defended by Adams. Stolen by Jackson. Morant surveying the D. Takes a three. Rebound by Joel Embiid. Embiid's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Brown the pass to... Embiid, stolen by Jackson. Here's Morant. No good off the back of the rim. Philadelphia leading by 9. Pass to Embiid. Here's Brown. Outside, Maxey. Embiid sets the pick for Harris. Here's Tucker. Basket is good. The assist from Harris. Tucker's got the lead up to 12 now for the 76ers. Morant outside. Shoots over Brown. The Grizzlies with another miss.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
And he gets the bucket. Embiid's got 10 points in the game.
Now look, he can certainly extend his range, but Embiid is very comfortable from distance.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Jackson a screen on Harris. Here's Brooks. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Here's Philadelphia. They're on a 10-2 run here. Brown the pass to Tucker. And he banks in the layup. He's got 8.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And guys, to go on a big run, get some breathing space, it has to be a great play on each end.
And so it's Philadelphia in command with a 16-point lead as the buzzer sounds. Their defense has been terrific.
Hey, everybody. In the first half, he was feeling it. Not just putting up points, but
now let's go ahead and recognize the Player of the Month Award recipient. And that is...
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. You have to like what you're seeing from Ja Morant.
No problem fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
And you love that mindset he has going at the rim. He hasn't settled for anything, and he's been the aggressor all game long.
And so in the game for the 76ers, on the block, it's Tucker next to Embiid. Brown out there with Tyrese Maxey, and it's Harris in at the small forward. Greg, you look at a player putting up big numbers on a losing team. How do you determine if those are quality numbers, so to speak?
You know, Kevin, it's a great question because somebody's going to put up points or collect rebounds or get assists. So, you know, you look at efficiency, you look at effort, and there's no doubt that you can have winning players on losing teams.
Here's Brooks. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Embiid's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
You know what? He's just stone cold right now. Really not sure if he's their best option offensively as they try to get back in this game. Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
Outside, Bane. Jackson setting the pick here for Bane. He takes it in. Basket counts. Bane's got 5 points so far.
Taking it right to the rim. One imagines that might be discussed at halftime. That's going to be on the film.
And so it's Harris who will bring it up for the 76ers. Their next game is at the Rockets Arena in Houston for a game with the Rockets. That'll be the last game of their very short 3-game road tour.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
One thing you have to admire about the Grizzlies is their high.
That's the right call, Rex.
Second
nice
personal
job.
Foul. First team foul. At the line for the Grizzlies, Ja Morant.
Plays are against some teams.
Yes, the talent and experience can only take you so far. But Memphis, these boys will outwork you. And in some ways, it's not fair because their energy at times just seems unmatchable.
And the dunk by Brown.
Hey, whatever adjustments they made at halftime, they are working to perfect.
Oh, yeah, I can't agree more. They haven't missed.
Morant outside. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. Up and in on the layup. He's got 13.
It's been all about Ja tonight. Can score in so many different ways.
Brown. Outside, Maxey. And Harris, wide open. He shoots another three for Philadelphia.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
And here's Brooks from outside. Maxey grabs the miss.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Embiid kicks to Maxey. And here's Brown outside. It's rebounded by Memphis. Jackson's got his fourth rebound in this one. Morant against Harris. On the wing, Brooks. Back to Bane. Down to five on the shot clock. There's the three. Maxey grabs the miss. Maxey's got four rebounds now tonight.
Let's just say his subpar shooting is just one reason why they are trailing in this ball game.
Brown outside. Kicks to Tucker. Jacks up a three. The rebound by Steven Adams.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Bane. And the rejection by Embiid. Here's Brown. The feed to Embiid. It's stolen by Adams. Floats it up there for Bane. Stolen by Tucker. Brooks against Brown. Down low. Out to Harris. Philadelphia moving the ball around. And the foul called on the great one. That's his first.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
Both teams will make substitutions. And the Grizzlies call their first timeout of the game.
Here they come, fans. Your Grizzlies workers tonight. How about some more cheers for your Grizzlies workers? Give them a hand.
Here's Jones. He's got nine. And there's the pass to Tillman. Here's Aldama. Kicks to Jones. Passes it to Conshaw. And another miss by Memphis. For Philadelphia, they've gone 6 of 8 on field goal attempts in the third. A 75% clip. It's Brown on the wing. Out to the right wing. Pass to Harden. He feeds it to Brown. Misses the layup. He had him with that pump fake. The Grizzlies have gone just 25% from the field here in the second half. They're 2 of 8. Pass to Concha. Kicks it out to Jones. To the paint. Here's Aldama. And that comes off the assist by Jones.
Love how selfless he is setting brick screens like this. Plays like that right there.
So it's Philadelphia winning this one easily.
That's the end of the game. Thank you once again for supporting the crowd here tonight. Make sure to get home safe and we'll
I'm give me a couple options.
Good game at 5.
All right, man, why don't you kick us off, Nate?
What do you think of the report that the team is considering packaging you and 3 unprotected first-round picks for Shep Owens?
Oh, man, I just wish that stuff would die down already, man. It's a John, talk to me, man.
Hey, have you spoken with management about these rumors?
Not really. I mean, they know where my head's at, you know. Okay, that's it? All right. Thanks, guys.
I see the scores about to move. Do you think I see it?
I want to see more consistency. Practice and in games to be able to continue to get better.
You'll be working with each player?
Personally, yes, but I want to talk to the team for full buy-in. We can be humble, we can be better.
Thank you. KG, real talk? I heard they've been clowning me out here. So how...
Oh, that's
Yo, if Miles Park don't respect me, Then I gotta teach him a lesson, simple and plain.
What's up, baby? Here we go, here we go, here we go. Yeah, man, I may bust it out this game.
All right.
Yeah, come on.
Come on, we're about to get it done. I got baseball.
the 16.